So here's a question for you. What do you get when you're in Hollywood and you decide to talk about and to accordingly call out woke people? Do you get headaches, maybe a little body pain, maybe some fatigue? I imagine fatigue. Well, apparently it goes further. If you listen to Lawrence Fox about what happened with him calling out 1917 and basically putting wokeness on blast, apparently he had people saying they wanted to Minecraft him. Sounds like fun, huh? Sounds like fun indeed. Hey there, so today we're going to look at something I like to call cause and effect. Cause, Lawrence Fox hits out at institutionalism over inclusion of a chic soldier in nominated 1917. He had an opinion on something. He decided to call out institutional wokeness. What was the effect of that? If you guessed NPCs going re-re-re all the way home, well, you are definitely correct. See, while Lawrence Fox says that he still stands by his comments, he says that he's received Minecrafting invitations after calling out quote-unquote woke people as being fundamentally ist. So what exactly transpired? Well, a couple of things, actually, over a week or so. So about a week before his 1917 comments, he was on BBC Question Time. And well, this is what this comes from, and a follow-up. So what were Lawrence Fox's comments about woke people? Fox accused academic Rachel Boyle of being ist after she branded him a white privileged male. Fox groaned and banged his head on the table, claiming Britain is the most tolerant, loving country in Europe. He added, "Oh my God, I can't help what I am. I was born like this. It's an immutable characteristic. To call me a white privileged male is to be ist. You're being an ist." He also brought up the Duchess of Suffolk in this, basically throwing that back in Rachel Boyle's face, which was all pretty funny. Then following up on this, he decided to quote-unquote double down on his claims about so-called wokest people. He told the host of a podcast this: "What they accuse you of is what they are. They accuse you of everything that they are. The wokest are fundamentally ist." He added, "Identity politics are extremely ist." He then went on later to reveal that he would never date a woman under the age of 35 because they're quote-unquote too woke. Speaking in the podcast, he said he no longer dates younger ladies because they're too woke, and many of them are absolutely bonkers. He said women under 35 are primed to believe they're victims. Fox then revealed he had broken up with an ex when she praised Gillette Adford, which highlighted toxic masculinity. He said, "I don't know how we ended up together. It was a very short relationship. We were walking down the road together, and she was talking about how good Gillette Advert was. I just looked at her and went, 'Bye. Sorry I can't be with you.'" Asked what his ex thought of him discussing their breakup in public, he said, "She will probably sit there and say, 'See, I told you he was patriarchal. He's abusing me, and I'm offended.'" It's not clear who he was referring to, and then they put in a picture of Billy Piper. So what exactly happened with regard to 1917? So speaking on James Dellingpole's broadcast, Fox revealed that seeing the actor N.R., sorry about not pronouncing the name, in the film, quote-unquote, diverted him from the story. He added that the, quote-unquote, oddness of the casting caused a, quote-unquote, very heightened awareness of the color of someone's skin. He said, "There were Sikhs fighting this war. Okay, you're now diverting me away from what the story is." He had also added, "There is something institutionally ist about forcing diversity on people in that way." Now, as far as backlash is concerned, Fox addressed this when appearing on Good Morning Britain and said the following: "I say quite a lot of unfortunate things, but it's important one is able to express their ideas." Now, when quizzed about the backlash by the host, he added, "I've got a small bout of hopefully temporary insomnia. I've had Minecraft invitations, and I have children." He also added that, "I 100% stand by the comments that he made, saying what is most important is that we seek out instances of ism and join together to condemn them." Then he was asked about his career, because he has different roles out there that are listed, and he was asked if it would impact it. He said, "Well, we'll have to wait and see. Does one want to work in a career where you have the right opinion? Art won't be improved." Wow, that is actually crazy that somebody stands up and says, "Hey, if I have to have that opinion, well then, I don't want to have that job." And with regard to that career and the actors that can impact it, yeah, he said some other things out there that made people mad. Like this. The most annoying thing is the minute a black actor, it's the same with working class actors, the minute they get 5 million quid in the bank, every interview they do is about how ism is rampant and ripe in the industry. Now here's one of the comments firing back, calling him irrelevant. I've been speaking up on the lack of work for black actors in the UK for about 20 years. I'm now acting in and directing American television, and I still don't have 5 million quid. Now the retweets calling out Fox read like this. Well said, the arts are in danger of becoming an exclusive preserve of privileged elites. Some posh shows have talent, of course, but some are just irritating egomaniacs who only got in because of money and connection. You can see other comments with that as well. Black and WC actors can only speak the truth once they're established. Their voices aren't heard before. Posh actors, on the other hand, only complain when they want attention. I mean, you can see this. You can see how that goes across, and man, it is good. But anyway, you tell me what you think about all of this madness, and well, I wonder what Fox will say next. Now, closing, I want to thank you for showing up, and thank you for participating. You make this stuff possible. If you'd like to help out the channel by subscribing to it and sharing these videos, that's awesome and definitely appreciated.